हेलो फ्रेंड, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द न्यू टेक्नोलॉजी, दैट इज द लेजर बीम मशीनिंग प्रोसेस। अर्लियर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द नॉन कन्वेंशनल मशीनिंग प्रोसेस, EDM, ECG, एब्रेसिव जेट, एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द लेजर बीम मशीनिंग। हियर वी आर यूजिंग द डिफरेंट सोर्स ऑफ एनर्जी टू रिमूव द मटेरियल। इट्स अ सब्स्ट्रक्टिव मैन्युफैक्चरिंग प्रोसेस। First thing is the full name of the laser. It is the light amplification by the stimulated emission of radiation. So here we are using the light energy which is amplified to remove the material. So you have to remember the full name, that is the light amplification by the stimulated emission of the radiation. So laser beam machining use the light energy, which is basically focused coherent beam of monochromatic light, to remove the material by the vaporization and the ablation, vaporization or melting of the surface through the heating by the friction. As we have conducted some experiment in the school level also, that we have a one glass which is focused, which is placed in the sunlight, and the light is focused on the normal paper. So that paper, after some time, that paper will burn out. So that is also an example that it is a one form of the concentrated energy. Basically, it's a light energy. The light energy is first so that the release energy result in an impulse against the work surface that produce the combination of the evaporation and melting with the melted material, evacuating the surface at the high velocity. So here we are using different component in combined with the laser. Basically we have to use the blower as well as the compression. We will discuss later on why we are using different component which is combined with the whole equipment. Here we are using the higher density. You can imagine that 100,000 kilowatt per centimeter square. So we are concentrating such high amount of energy on the small area. So there are there are different types of the laser that using the different source, like solid state, gas or liquid. In metal processing, solid state and gas are generally used. Here the laser used in metal processing are ND glass, neodymium glass. This is ND glass. The carbon dioxide, second is the carbon dioxide, and third is the neodymium drop, yttrium, aluminium garnet. So this is commonly used, NDYAG. So the name is somewhat complicated, but you have to remember that types of laser is used. Laser beam are being used for a variety of industrial application, including heat treatment, even in welding, measurement, as well as the cutting, drilling, slitting, slotting, marking operation and scrubbing. So we will discuss in detail later on. But the laser, as compared to the other non-conventional machining process, has a wide range of application. So laser beam machining does not involve mass material removal rate, but does provide rapid material removal rate with easily controlled non-contact, non-wearing tool. As we compared laser beam machining with the other non-conventional machining process, here we will produce a very thin slot. Here material removability is not the important parameter. Highly collimated light rays in the beam are almost perfectly parallel and diverging angle of less than 1 or 2 milliradians. So what we are doing, we are using different lenses to concentrate the high amount of the light energy on the single point. So the diameter you will get after cutting, that is the somewhat larger than the laser beam. Monochromatic, all the photons have the same energy and hence the same frequency and wavelength. So here we are using two types of focus. Now we are using a different component for laser machine, that main three components: a laser medium, a collection of atoms, molecules or ions, pumping energy source required to excite these atoms to high energy level, and optical feedback system. So this optical feedback system, which is a focus system, you can see this full schematic diagram of the laser beam machine. Here starting from the reflecting meter from left hand side, here we have a total reflecting meter, here we have flash lamp that will travel, and here we will get the laser beam. Here we have partial mirror. We will discuss all the component in detail, but here we are discussing the overall component. This is the monochromatic coherent line. Now that will transfer to the lens. Then what will happen? That lens will concentrate all the energy at a single point. Here you can see that is the focal length. That is the length between the lens and the workpiece. And workpiece is fixed in the fixture and it is connected with the table. Here you can directly use the work table, because here we are using the honeycomb structure work table. So what will happen when it travel in x and y direction, that due to the acceleration the workpiece is displaced. So it is required to fix the workpiece at some point, but the cutting force is zero. Here the cutting force is zero, and you can see here a protective tab which is basically used to avoid the unconcentrated laser beam. So that will be removed from here. In left hand side you can see the cooling system. Basically we are producing the high energy with the help of the flash lamp. So you remember that when we use the electrical energy, it will generate the high temperature, because we are using the coils and high amount of the supply. So it will generate the high temperature. So it should be replaced with the help of the water. So we require a cooling system to cool down the whole system. Here the in second diagram you can see that here we have a flash lamp which is connected with the power supply. Basically flash lamp is nothing but it's a coil. So it will generate the photon, electron, so that will be traveled with the help of the acceleration system. Here we have a laser crystal, reflective end, partial reflective end, lens and workpiece. So here you will get some idea that we are using the crystalline material. Now we'll discuss in detail. Like here we have power source which is connected with the flash lamp, and here we have a ruby crystal material. Basically, this flash lamp is the neon lamp, so it will produce the high amount of the light energy, and which is reflected on the ruby crystal material. Now we will discuss how laser is generated. What we are doing, we are supplying to the flash lamp, and then flash lamp will generate the high amount of energy. Here we have a ruby crystal as a lacing material, and the ruby crystal material is which is coated with the some impurities. So what is the function of the impurity? When we supply the energy, it will excite. Basically, we are using chromium material as impurity. So when we are supplying the high amount of energy to the impurity, it will excite. As the amount of energy is increasing, it will move the upper level. As we are supplying energy to the electron, it will jump from the lower to the higher energy level. And at the left hand side, we have a total reflective mirror. So zero energy will transfer from the left hand side. So what will happen? The excited electron that will travel toward the right hand side. So it will also transfer energy to some other impurities, iron. So the total energy that will transfer continuously to the right hand side. And here we have partial mirror. So partial mirror, a mirror allows the energy toward the lens, and it will also stop the low energy beam, and the energy which is released in the form of the light. So that's why this technology is called the light amplification. Here what we are doing, we are amplified the light, and after that here we are stimulated that light, and which is concentrated on the workpiece. So you can see that from the partial mirror we have a laser beam that is transferred from the laser, and which is connected to the workpiece at the end point. So the workpiece get evaporated, and that evaporated material which was forced out by the compressor, and at the end we have a blower. So that will be absorbed by the blower, and it will throw outside the machine. So this is a complete arrangement of the laser beam machine. And in next lecture we will discuss the some detail in application, then advantage, disadvantage. Thank you.